The cranial nerves have different names, they have different functions, but it's really your everyday life. So what I always encourage my medical students to do is, when you do anything during your day, you go to the shops and buy something, or you go to the restaurants and eat something, talk about it. How can you actually feel the taste?
In my first year of medical school, Krisztina was one of my lecturers. I was really fortunate this year to be able to help out with teaching the medical students. Krisztina has come up with a lot of creative ideas to deliver the material to the students and to us as a demonstrator, so we can improve and deliver the content well. She has a lot of ideas in terms of integrating the material that we cover in lectures and the material that we cover in practice, so that we understand the anatomy as well as the physiology we cover in class.
The way that Krisztina teaches is really, really hands-on. She teaches a theory slide, but she also gets students involved in a lot of the practical aspects. She gets us to play with models and actual hands-on experiments, and always wants us to start off doing lab work.
I find Krisztina's approach to teaching very impressive, because she integrates everything that the students learn from the beginning of the course up till the end, so that the students have a better understanding of what anatomy is and not just learning through different systems. In some of the assessments, she even includes getting the students to come up with learning tools on how to study for anatomy. Studying for anatomy is quite challenging because there's a lot of memory work. And because of these methods that Krisztina has devised, it has been very enjoyable, very fun, and very productive.
As a lecturer, as a teacher, she was always really easily approachable. And the way that she lectured and the way that she approached each subject, she tried to kind of tailor it to the student in kind of a fun and interactive way. She's very, very intelligent, but at the same time, she's very down to earth. She's very enthusiastic. And her passion gave me the passion to learn anatomy and to continue studies in biology.
My present research is about retinal degeneration, but mainly of AMD, which is the age-related macular degeneration, which is the leading cause of blindness over the age of 50 and beyond. I'm working with Professor Jan Provis and her group, and we are looking at inflammatory mechanisms and also gene changes and on the cellular level as well. Yes, I think students are important in research, so I often have students in my laboratory. Every year I have multiple honors students who are coming off their undergraduate studies. They need a lot of help at the beginning, but it's just fantastic to see them at the end of the year being very confident, producing the thesis, and they just have all those skills with them, and suddenly they grow up in that 1 year. So it's very important to include them in our research.
Having known Krisztina, having her as one of my great lecturers, I've had the opportunity to experience her very unique way of teaching, getting us to think outside the box. I have this new whole perspective of how teaching is delivered here at the ANU, which is the most important thing after all. It's what we're here for. We're here to learn, and to learn in different ways, in more creative ways.